Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see about nested loops and its working. When you repeat a loop a number of times, it is called nested loop. So that means if you have a loop, it will repeat a number of statements repeatedly until the condition is satisfied. Now if you have a loop inside another loop which is repeated number of times, then it is called as a nested loop. It can be applied when the internal loop repeats for a given number of times for each iteration of an external loop. So you can see here an example of a wall clock where you have three pins, hours pin and minutes pin and seconds pin. So you can see that seconds pin will go one full rotation, so that the minutes pin will move 1 point. Same like that, when the minutes pin go around full rotation to move the hour spin to one full hour. So it goes on like that. The same working will be for the nested loop. So the internal loop will execute one full set of iterations so that it will update the outer loop. Now you can see an structure of a nested loop. First you will have initialization statement where it will initialize the control variable of the outer loop and enters into the condition of the outer loop. If the condition is true, it enters into the inner loop where it will check the condition. If the condition of the inner loop is true, it goes on to execute the body of the loop of body of the inner loop. After executing the body, it will go to the updation statement where it will increase or decreases the control variable and goes back to the condition statement of the inner loop, and then this process will go on till the condition of the inner loop gets satisfied. Once it gets satisfied, it comes out of it and then goes back to the updation statement of the outer loop where it increases or decreases the control variable and then checks the condition of the outer loop. If the condition is true, it enters the inner loop again. So this process will go on till the outer loop condition becomes false. Once it becomes false, it comes out of the loops. So this is how the nested loop will work. Now we are going to see a sample program example for nested loops. Here you have two loops, for loops, where the outer for loop will be having the initial value 1 and it executes till 3. That means this outer loop will work 3 times. You can see the updation statement increases by 1, so it executes 3 times. You go into the inner loop, here you can see the initial value is 1, again the condition statement is going till 3 and increases the control variable by 1 here. So this loop also will go on execute the body of the loop for 3 times. So it will be like this, the initial value will be stored and then it goes into the condition of the loop. If the condition is true, say where 1 is lesser than or equal to 3, so if it is true, it goes into the inner loop. Here the condition, the initialization statement will be executed, so j value will have 1 and it checks the condition. If the condition is true, it enters into the body of the loop. So here 1 is lesser than 3, so it enters, it prints the j value. So you can see the first value 1, that is the j value is printed. After printing it, the body of the loop is completed. It goes to the updation statement of the inner loop, check increases the value by 1, checks the condition again. If the condition is true, that means 2 is lesser than 3, it enters the body of the loop, prints j again, so that is a value 2 has been printed here. Then again goes back to the updation statement, increases the value by 1, so it becomes 3. So 3 is not lesser than 3, but it is equal to 3, so it enters into the body of the loop again, prints j value. So you can see j value 3 has been printed. Okay. After which again it goes to the updation statement where it increases the value of j by 1, so it becomes 4. Now 4 is not lesser than or not equal to 3, so the condition is false, so it stops the inner loop. It goes to the outer loop updation statement, it increases the I value by 1. So already I value is 1 here, it increases by 1, so it becomes 2. It goes to the condition statement, now 2 is lesser than 3, so condition is true. So it enters the inner loop, again j value becomes 1, and then it executes 3 times. So that's why you are getting 1, 2, 3 again. Okay, again it goes to the outer loop after completing it. Then you can see the I value is increased by 1, so it becomes 3. Again, it is not lesser than 3, but it is equal to 3. It enters the inner loop, and you can see again the same set of process has been executed. So you can notice one thing, that if you have 3 into 3, it will work for 9 times. So if it is 5 into 5, it becomes 25 times. So this is how the nested loop will work. And you can notice if it is more normally this inner loop or outer loop, nested loops basically used for pattern programs. But you can see here, it is not looking like a pattern. It is printing the numbers in the same line. Now if you want to print it in like a pattern, row by row, we have to add one system.println statement. Okay, if the system.println statement is included in the outer loop, that means after the inner loop is executed for 3 times, you can see 1, 2, 3 has been printed. Okay, before going to, after the condition is false, before going to the updation statement of the outer loop, it executes the statements below the inner loop. So you have a statement here. After executing it, you go to the updation statement and follow the process again. So that's how you are getting the pattern type program. Now we are going to see how the nested while loop will work. So you already seen about while loops. You will have initialization statement, which is defined outside the loop, and then the condition, and inside the body of the loop you will have an updation. So if you have a nested loop, the working will be like this. You will have an initialization statement outside the loop, then the while statement, and then the condition. After the condition is checked, if the condition is true, it enters into the body of the outer while loop. And again you can see the initialization statement of the control variable of inner while loop is been initialized, and then you can check the condition of the while loop, inner while loop. If the condition is true, it enters the body of the inner while loop, execute the statement, then updation has been done, and this loop will be executed till the condition is true. So you can see this one full iteration will print the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, no, okay, one row. After printing it, it condition will be true, that is false. Once it becomes false, it goes to the goes out of the body of the inner loop. You got remaining two statements here. So it, the first statement will break the line. Okay, system on println will break the line. So once that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or the first row has been printed, the cursor will move on to the next line, and then you can see the updation statement. Okay, after updation statement, it goes back to the outer while loop. It checks the condition. If the condition is true, it enters the body of the outer loop, and this process will go on. So you can see the condition is this loop will work, outer loop will work for 5 times. Okay, because I value is 1, I less than or equal to 5, and I plus plus. So this will work 5 times. Inner loop also, I j value is 1, j less than or equal to 5, and j plus plus. So this also works 5 times. So 5 into 5, you can see 25 times the loop will nested loops will work. So you'll have 25 different outputs here. Same way you are going to see about nested do while loop. This process is same, only thing is instead of while you have to use do, remaining everything is same. Okay, and you can see the outer loop while has been the last line of the program. Okay, and then it has to end with a semicolon, and then once the condition is true, it enters the inner loop, the body of the outer loop, and then you have a do while statement again inside the body of the outer loop. It executes the statement of body of the inner loop and then checks the condition. If the condition is true, it continue working. Okay, till the condition is false. If the condition is false, it comes out of the inner loop, executes the statement below. After that updation statement, it checks the condition and it goes on executing it. So output will be same for this program also. So this is how the nested loop will work. Okay, so we will see different pattern programs in upcoming videos. So till then, thank you.